Namaste, dear students. I'd like to welcome you in my third class. The subject is science, and class 6. So, as you know, we have discussed first day about the measurement and why measurement is important and how to define units, and secondly we have discussed about the system of units like amperes, cgs, amperes system we have discussed, and we have discussed about SI units. Then after we have discussed why it is SI unit is important. So today in third day class we'll discuss about fundamental units and next one is derived units. First we'll discuss how to define fundamental units, and thereafter in this chart we'll discuss this chart. Okay dear student? So fundamental units can be defined as the unit which are independent of other units, which are independent of other unit, which unit depend itself, those type of unit known as fundamental unit. Okay, which unit depend itself or independent of other unit, that is known as fundamental unit. So you can say I have made a chart here, name and symbol of fundamental unit. So you have listened the physical quantity also. So physical quantity means the quantity which can measure, which can be measured, that known as physical quantity. These all term are physical quantity. These all term are physical quantities. Just like length, mass, time, temperature, electric current, luminous intensity, amount of substances. They all are physical quantities. And what are their SI units? I have written here. And how they can be represented in a symbolic? They are here. If you learn this chart, then you get very easy and you feel very easy. Okay dear student? So first physical quantity is length. Length is SI unit is meter and it is symbolized as m. Second physical quantity is mass. It is SI unit is, its SI unit is kilogram and its symbol is kg. Third physical quantity time, and its unit is second, second, and symbol is S. Similarly, temperature symbol is SI unit is Kelvin and symbol is K. Electric current, its SI unit is ampere, ampere, and its symbol is A. A next physical quantity is luminous intensity. Luminous intensity, its SI unit is candela, CANDEL candela, and it represents as CD. Okay? And next is amount of substance, and its SI unit is MOLE mole, and symbol is MOLE. So dear student, why I have present these all things in chart? What is the reason behind it? Kino wale chart ko dikhaya hua tha? Your physical quantity, these physical quantities, SI unit, you must learn that. If anybody talk about meter, then you think that is talking about the length. If anybody talk about the kilogram, then you must know they are talking about the mass. If they are talking about the second, then you must know they are talking about the time. If anybody talking about the Kelvin, then you must know he is talking about the temperature. If anybody is talking about the ampere, then you must know he is talking about the electric current. If anybody talking about the candela, then you must know luminous intensity. And if anybody is talking about the mole, the amount of substance is talking. You have to understand that. And even after numerical problem, by getting the answer of numerical problem, if question is to find out the length, then you should write the width. Okay? After that, after getting the answer, we should write meter. If you have to find out calculation, you have to calculate the mass, then you should write after the getting the answer. With that, you have to write the kilogram. In numerical problem, also you will understand that. So, it is clear? Can I go ahead? Next point? Okay, thank you. So, let's discuss about derived. Next unit is derived. The unit which are derived from fundamental unit. The unit which are derived from fundamental unit. Tesla unit to fundamental what is derived by answer. Those unit are that unit are called derived unit. Okay? Any confusion, dear student? Oh, thank you. So same again, I have made a chart, name and symbol of some derived SI unit, and you will find out after looking this chart, you will find out that how derived unit is derived from fundamental unit. By this chart, I will make clear. Okay? So focus everybody, you focus toward me. Tapayaru makri dhyani wala. So again, I have written physical quantities, name and unit, and symbol. These three things are same. And then after, I have written a fundamental unit involved. That's why fundamental unit involved. Stopper. How is it involved here? How derived unit involved in fundamental unit? So physical quantity are written as area. What? Area, then similarity volume, velocity, work, then after I have written here force. So same area, SI unit is per candle, unit is square meter. S-Q-U-A-R-E, square meter. Symbol is meter square. How many m here? M, 2m, 3m, 3 square. Volume, cubic meter, meter cube, m into m into m, 3m, so we have that m into m into m. Velocity, meter per second, it is a unit of physical quantity. Physical quantity, the unit of velocity is meter per second, so meter is m. Or means divide, s per second means yes, meter per second. You can see here. And work, unit is joule, j, kg into meter, r divided by second into second. Force, unit is newton, it is present at, its symbol is n, kg into m, or s into s. We can write this thing. Like this also, kg m per second square. This can be written as kg meter square or square like that. Alright, okay. So how it is important? How it is derived from? How derived unit is derived from fundamental unit? So see here, there are two meters. Meter is fundamental unit. Which unit? Fundamental unit, or SI unit. So there are two units, two meter, so it is depend upon a fundamental unit. Similarly, this also you can say. Second is also SI unit, a fundamental unit. Meter is also a fundamental and SI unit. So there are meter and also second So we can say by this way we can say this derived unit is derived from fundamental unit. So dear student, I think you are clear here. I think no confusion. No confusion you have. So dear student, I like to give you some question for your homework. You should firstly you should learn that, and you all the things what I taught you, you keep in your mind. Then you write your own self. Okay, don't see the books and note like this, and you should write yourself. First is define fundamental unit. Define derived unit and why it is depend on why it is depend on. Okay, only this two question only. Okay, define fundamental unit and next question is to number is define derived unit. Or dear student, should do your homework, and for today this marks. Thank you.